Hi, good morning and welcome to today's morning report on Monday the 23rd of February with me, Richard Perry, market analyst at Hantech Markets. European trading sessions got off to a bit of a mixed start actually. DAX is quite strong and that's coming on the back of this agreement between Greece and the Euro group on Friday. Slight improvement in market sentiment on the back of that agreement, but there's still a lot to sort out. There still needs to be this economic reform proposal that Greece has to put forward, that the Eurogroup has to subsequently agree to in order to go down this road of kicking the can further down the road for another 4 months of this bailout extension that Greece has secured. Now, the reason that FTSE is not higher today is largely due to the fact that HSBC, one of its largest constituents, is down quite significantly on its results, around 5% or so down early trading today on HSBC, and that has certainly impacted on the FTSE negatively, down 0.2% on the FTSE, and it shied away from a test of the all-time high. 6940 there or thereabouts was the high that it reached today, and it's just come back and it's now back towards 6900 again. But the DAX continues to push strongly higher. That's nicely into new high ground. However, you did have a slightly disappointing IFO number. Germany IFO business climate came out slightly lower than expectations, and that sort of pulled the DAX slightly down from its highs of earlier in the day. But that's my chart of the day, and I'll look at that in a bit. But certainly the markets in terms of equities are positive, but we've had quite a significant, there was a big move on Friday towards the euro, gaining around 150 pips on the news of that euro agreement, agreement between Greece and the euro group. However, there's been a slide backwards today. Euro's down 60 pips today, and that's sort of helping this dollar index to slightly regain some upside, but you can still see this consolidation that we're in on this dollar index. Nothing too significant in terms of gains, but certainly it seems as though this general consolidation on this dollar index continues, really. It looks like certainly the gold price is not benefiting on the back of that. It's broken back below 1200, it's broken back to I think a 7 week low now on the gold price, continues to slide back towards that 100% retracement fib level that I'll talk about in my gold chart analysis in a bit. Now, in terms of economic data today, I said we've had the German IFO. We've got this afternoon now at 3 o'clock UK time, you've got the US existing home sales, which is forecast to come in slightly down at 4.97 million, down from 504 last month, and that would just be slightly above that low that we saw in November, 492. It certainly seems as though that these existing home sales have just sort of tipped over now, and it certainly seems as though it's sort of just beginning to slide somewhat. So that's not a great bit of news if that comes out. So we'll see how that goes at 3 o'clock this afternoon. That's the only real bit of data we've got to look forward to today. So we'll see how that goes. But my chart today, as I said, is the DAX. And this is the DAX on the hourly chart. And we've seen a strong move in the early opening trades today, because we got that agreement out of the Eurogroup after hours on Friday night. And it certainly seems as though the DAX, sorry, wrong chart on the daily, this is the daily DAX chart. It's broken up now above that 100% fib level. I've been talking about this level, this fib projection level, for a while now as being a key level that we need to watch out for on the DAX. Sort of that October to December rally projected from that December low. It gives us a fib projection 100% of 10,950 or there or thereabouts. It struggled to get through there, but now we've had one, two closes above it, and it's now trading above it again today. Looks like it's sort of beginning to start to pull away from that level. And what you do is you then start to think about the next fib level on the upside, which is 12,020 area. So that would be your next major target to the upside. And There's no real reason why the DAX can't continue to go there. Obviously, with all this quantitative easing that's going to be sloshing around, I don't see why the DAX won't get there in the medium to long term. But certainly looks like this breakout is strong. The momentum indicators look strong. Stochastics in positive configuration again. RSI pushing back towards the 70 mark, which is a positive mark for that. So just a lot of boxes that are suggesting this is a good strong chart. You look at the 21 day moving average, which has been a nice basis of support, has worked out previously that way, and it certainly looks as though that is just beginning to now flank these gains. So you'd be looking out for subsequently, I think, if you did see any sort of real correction on a sort of a couple of days worth of basis, maybe 3 days, you'd be looking out for that 21 day moving average, which, as I said, comes in around about 10,850 now. So we're looking pretty strong on the DAX, and it looks like it's although it's has come back from that EFO data, I still think that that's going to be a fairly strong move to the upside. It's maybe just closing or filling this gap that we had out from the open. 11.0811. So currently just around about that, where that gap is now. So just beginning to fill that gap, and I think that that could be also helpful for the run higher. So that's my outlook for the DAX, and I wish you good luck in your trading today, and I'll speak to you later. Thank you.